Well, sir, you have here a really wonderful set of six decanter or bottle coasters. What do you know about them? Let's start with you.
Well, very little, other than that we bought them in 1976 in Scotland. That's about all.
They're very typically Scottish in that they are this very severe, they're very, very plain, with a nice gadrooned rim, turned mahogany bases, and they're engraved with absolutely typical Scottish crests here. The motto goes over the top of the crest, which is always Scottish. They are made, in fact, in Edinburgh in 1801 by Mr. James Dempster. And I have, in fact, discovered that the crests are that of a family called Hamilton Dalrymple of Northberwick, I think Northberwick, but they're baronets. The family's extinct now, which is no doubt why they, at some point they came on the market. What's very interesting, you know, is you see sets of four, obviously pairs of coasters, quite often, sets of four and sets of six, sometimes even more. But what is so difficult is to find more than a pair of decanters. Sets of six decanters almost don't exist. So I often wonder whether so many decanters have been broken, or in fact, these were more often used for bottles. Because sets of six decanters are incredibly rare. Rare. But those are absolutely lovely. Lovely coasters. How much would you guess?
Well, they're insured for around about the 1500.
Right.
I wouldn't like to guess because I've never seen a set of six.
No. Well, I certainly have seen sets of six, and I think a set of six really, really plain, super Edinburgh coasters today would fetch around about £6,000 to £8,000.
Good grief.
Yes. I'll just take a deep breath.
Yes.
they're marvellous.
Shocked me.
So, oh dear.
Do you find it fun?
No, I think it's quite an ugly thing. I've never looked at it with a great deal of pleasure.
So it's not anything you treasure at home at all?
No, it hasn't really. It's been in various places, such as under the stairs and different places, and it's never been a thing that I would... Oh, that is nice, I'd like to keep it.
That's awful, because it's got so much charm. It's sort of a cartoon-like quality, I find, which so many of this sort of figure tends to represent. It's so appealing. It's the work of a potter known as, lovely name, Obadiah Sherrett. He was working in Staffordshire in the 1820s, and his groups are very typified by these high-score bases and the marvellous mixed-up scale of his portraiture. You've got little tiny sheep, and the figures, I mean, completely dwarfing the castle which they're supposed to be standing beside. I know of a couple of versions of this model. One misses out the sheep altogether, but they always have a tower on both sides of the figure. And here, rather amusingly, the second tower broke off during the making. But rather than scrap the piece, they went ahead and just cut it down, painted over it and glazed it, and so you wouldn't know, and it's no longer there. So you presumably don't think it's a terribly valuable piece.
Well, no, I've never really thought of it as anything. It's just been there.
Recently, some incredibly high prices have been paid in sales for the work of Sherrett, his quick groups of circus performers and local social history of Staffordshire, which many of these pieces represent, are seriously sought by collectors nowadays. And I can understand, probably find several collectors will be quite willing to pay £2,000 for this group.
Oh, golly Moses, I can hardly believe that. Well, when you think how I've looked at it, never even had any pleasure from looking at it, I find it difficult to...
So it's a primitive sort of pleasure that, honestly, to me, I see it very differently to you. But
yes.
I hope perhaps you'll now, after realising this, you'll look at it in a new light.
I should cherish it, I should think, from now onwards.